want to welcome you all, Senhor of Maurício Peixoto, at the end of this afternoon, about the importance of Maurício to IMPA and to the Brazilian mapping. Let's go directly to the first talk. It is my pleasure to announce the first speaker, who's Sergei Novikov, and from University of Maryland and Landau Institute. He is going to talk about ground state of 2D supersymmetric Pauli operator in magnetic fields and soliton theory.
Okay. I don't remember first time when I met Mauricio Peixoto. It was many years ago. But what I am aware of is that in early 60s I already heard his name when structural stability started to discuss actively. It was long before I met him personally. And it was interesting period. And quite recently I looked into Wikipedia. What is written about that early period in structural stability. And I found some interesting information that was, maybe I can explain to people which don't know about that. It is written that when Mauricio, who was originally, I would say, had engineering background, came to these problems and solved it for two-dimensional manifolds, he approached a famous mathematician, Pantragin, whom he worshipped as a creator of that fundamental idea, just tried to tell him about his works, and met no response. Pantragin did not interested at all what is written in Wikipedia. Everybody might check this, but it is so. Even Mauricio was impressed, even it was included in Wikipedia article, this information. Let me extend this statement and tell you that even when famous work of Steve Smale was, and my friend Anosov in early 60s already, Pantragin also did not express any interest as well. That was, the relation was quite similar. And even Mauricio probably don't know explanation of that, but I know it. And it is typical relationship between mathematicians and physicists. He did not express interest by one simple reason, because he was not author of that idea at all, had nothing to do with that. His name is there, yes. There was physicist Andronov who produced this idea. He was friend of my father and knew his family, so I knew about that problem also. But you normally, as physicists did, writing work, mathematical work of physicists, always there will be some gap. It's impossible to imagine mathematical works of physicists without gap. And Pantragin pointed out him gap. Some small gap was good gap, not small, like that for structurally stable system, there are no separatrices joining to saddle points, like that. It's only, just Andronov included, asked him, included him in his name, but he never interested this idea, never produced this idea, never had any ideology about that, never interested in works of Mauricio, Smale, Anosov, and latest in that area. So this is what I just wanted to tell you about that stuff. That this guy Andronov created big school in dynamical systems, also in Gorky City, in Nizhny Novgorod City, both mathematical and more with physics. He was very important applied physicist at that time, also created beautiful mathematical ideas. But frequently people attribute between interaction between two communities is such that they frequently attribute work not to real authors, but to first person of their own crowd who brought it to them. It's a very typical behavior. So, but in that case, I just wanted to tell you about that. Found out that Mauricio did not know, was even insulted that Pantragin did not express interest to his idea. Let me tell you about, come to my own talk. And just the quotation of my article is always very simple. I stopped to quote any article, journals, and so. I made everything in my homepage, and you can click and get it sitting on your table. It started when some physicists told me that they interested in one of your work, but could not find it. I told him that it is published, yes, well, in English, well. He told me, no, that's, who is looking for that? People are sitting in their office, they click, that's it. If they cannot find it, so that's, you did not publish. So that's, you can take all my works from my homepage, click and get it sitting in your office, yes. And it is written here. My work is dedicated to the quantum mechanics, non-relativistic quantum mechanics. You have to keep in mind that quantum mechanics is non-relativistic. It is relativistic and non-relativistic, but relatively rigorous mathematical science with set of, say, axioms, mathematics is only non-relativistic quantum mechanics, so therefore it does not cover all real physical quantum processes. Non-relativistic quantum mechanics is my subject here, and based on some relationship with dynamical systems. But it is not dynamical systems in like you are studying typically in qualitative theory of finite dimensional dynamical systems. We are dealing with infinite dimensional dynamical systems given by partial differential equations and some special interesting systems of that kind are completely integrable. What does it mean? Let me tell you what does it mean. That's complete integrability. We consider it this object not in just strict elementary sense like it is normally people are doing for finite dimensional Hamiltonian systems, but our systems are constructed on the spaces of functions, and we don't care seriously whether how to just complete this, to write this in proper Hilbert space, existence, uniqueness systems. It is, some people are doing that, in pure mathematicians, but you have to take into account that all these equations, even if when they were derived physically, do not need such, I would say, detailed studying. Only some special families of important solutions might be really important. So in our community, people don't respect really even deep results when some guy proved existence in some spaces and so on. That Hilbert, it might be difficult, but people will say uninteresting. These equations are normally considered in for smooth functions, and they're derived in such a way that only special important solutions are interesting. There are very interesting classes of solutions. There are two typical modern types. Typical modern process of approaching to infinite dimensional, completely integrable PDE systems. Most famous of them is famous KDV, Kurtevec DeVries systems, whose integrability was discovered by infamous work of Martin Kruskal and others in 1960s. Later, Peter Lux made some very useful methodological understanding of it, but it was not his discovery. Martin Kruskal and others. In the scattering transform, and it is based on the relationship between nonlinear equation known since 19th century and linear operators. When anyone might check this directly, take this operator, construct commutator, and you will see that this equation for operator is arithmetically equivalent to this system for coefficients. Elementary exercise, I would say, one-page calculation. There are similar systems. It's interesting that number of completely integrable systems is relatively small, but they are interesting because there are extremely interesting and important systems between them. It turns out that these systems of that kind became even more important in different areas of pure mathematics, not only to several areas for physics. There are a lot of other systems except KdV. There are also, this is one-dimensional system, one-dimensional case. One means x is one. There are also two-dimensional systems, where Kp, let me avoid to saying, which also can be presented in the same way. People call this Lux representation of dynamical system. You see that if you have a real smooth but function u, L is u serves, consider it as a potential for Schrödinger operator, and this is unitary, family of unitary transformation of this operator if A is Q-symmetric operator. So it is like Heisenberg equation in quantum mechanics. So spectrum of operator is gives you set of conservation laws. If you are working in proper space of functions, you hear like periodic or rapidly decreasing, most important classes. There exists even complete integration procedure of this equation for specific functional classes, like rapidly decreasing in X, so-called solitons, or periodics. There are also two-dimensional analogs of that, which are degenerate. We call them three 1.5-dimensional cases, like famous Kp equation also, and some others. Also with similar type representation. But for really non-degenerate two-dimensional systems, right analog of Lux representation looks, in fact, a little bit more complicated. You have to add additional term here, B, A and B, such that this is nonlinear system is equivalent to such dynamics. There are important, interesting, physically interesting two-dimensional systems, I will explain you why I don't even write it at the moment. This representation was found in 1976, many years ago, in our group in Landau Institute. Our group and Zakharov's group together, jointly. And in this case, simply operator L is a famous two-dimensional Schrödinger operator, the general two-dimensional second-order linear operator. One might ask, following question, what does it mean, this representation? What is it algebraically? What is difference of first one and second one? Algebraic difference between these two formulas is following. That in first case, KdV, you have family of equivalent operators, just unitary equivalent operators, L of T. In second case, you don't have that, but you have time dependence, which is similar, looks like equivalence, but only for the set of functions psi, such that L psi is equal to zero, such this term disappears. So it is like, I would say, unitary equivalence corresponding to one selected energy level, spectral level. Well, that's for, don't think that one point of spectrum is only, say, one eigenfunction. It is not so. It is big families in important boundary conditions in solid state physics and scattering theory. There are two ways to use this representation. That's why it explains why I don't write dynamical systems, important, interesting dynamical systems, which appeared here, physically interesting. First way, from spectral theory to linear operator, of linear operator, to the solutions of nonlinear system. Suppose you already know everything about operator L. For example, for the case when potential U of xt for any given moment of t is soliton-like, means rapidly decreasing in x, there exists known famous theory of Gelfand, Levitan, and Marchenka, inverse scattering problem which was solved for the needs of quantum theory in early 1950s. So everything is known about that, and we can use it in order to construct solution of nonlinear equation. It was called, therefore, inverse scattering transform. In our case, a case of periodic functions in X and quasi-periodic, which was solved also in 1970s in our works, was different. In that case, spectral theory was not prepared enough. And in order to solve KdV problem, nonlinear problem, we needed to develop both of them simultaneously using this representation. It turns out that fundamental family of solutions was found, so-called algebraically geometric or finite gap periodic Schrödinger operators, and corresponding family of solutions of nonlinear KdV equations. They were found, both theories were developed simultaneously in that case. In that case, instead of inverse scattering transform, in order to reconstruct linear operators from some data originated from spectral theory, you have to take data similar to algebraic geometry of Riemann surfaces, like Riemann surface divisors, abelian varieties appears here, theta functions, and all these calculus. And for both theories, it was new for spectral theory of periodic operators, as well as for Schrödinger KdV equations. In case of KdV equations, when these guys, Kertévék and de Vries, discovered these equations in late 1890s, 19th century, they found some first simple traveling way, and it was, just by calculation, it was elliptic functions, but this connection with algebraic geometry, special functions, Riemann surfaces, was clarified only within this theory, I would say, 80 years later, in the 1970s. So this is relationship between dynamical systems and Schrödinger operators. There are a lot of people used it, but let me tell you following. In order to use this type of procedures, you cannot solve these nonlinear equations like KdV or Kp or others, which appears here, making elementary procedures like substitute that function into that and so on. No way. This is not elementary integrable systems. You have to use fundamental properties of whole class of functions like rapidly decreasing or periodic, and use some global fundamental procedure, scattering transform or classical algebraic geometry and theta functions and so on. If you have some more complicated classes of functions like needed for studying so-called self-similar solutions, random matrices problem leads to Stoliton theory between modern famous achievements, you need to consider more complicated classes of functions, and these procedures became much less effective. So it is really global stuff. There are a lot of stuff which is going on even now, but it is much. But this sort is completely non-local. So this is what our goal is, to extend this idea to the special case of very important operator for which it was not solved. The two-dimensional, purely magnetic Pauli operator, which is the title of my talk. It is a special case to which these Soliton ideas did not work before. It was investigated a lot by physicists and mathematicians in quantum mechanics. This is my goal. This problem, which we solved quite recently this year, only which existed long ago. This is just, it's not new theory, it is just we were capable to solve this problem, to use this soliton type approach to study fundamental quantum mechanical two-dimensional operators, Pauli operator, which describes motion of like spin 1/2 means electron type particles along the surface in magnetic field, orthogonal to the surface, and no electric field. It's important. Let me just give you some information about history of that subject. This is now about Pauli operator. This is, let me tell you following. In mathematics literature, Schrödinger, two-dimensional Schrödinger operator, scalar Schrödinger operator, was considered a lot by many people. But almost 100% of rigorous math literature was dedicated to operators with zero magnetic field. It's just Laplacian plus potential, real potential. It's almost all. But physical operator requires additional magnetic field, and for that case, that's few works can be found in the literature. And we are going to deal with magnetic field. Let me tell you following. Magnetic field is interesting quantity. All topological phenomena in physics are coming from magnetic field. Or some, it's more complicated analogs like Young-Mills field. All, everywhere, no exception. Without magnetic field, there are no interaction of topology with physics at all. That's all serious. I mean real application of topology. But for real physically observable phenomena, for example, such beautiful areas of topology like knot theory, for example, does not have any applications until now. People expect that it might have, but not so. But all applications of topologies are associated with magnetic field and quantum theory. Or even more complicated stuff than magnetic field like Young-Mills field. Or with some mathematical analog of magnetic field, like vorticity in hydrodynamics, so that's what, like that. What's so, magnetic field or something like that. Let me just tell you that history of study of Pauli operator is very interesting. Pauli is just fundamental guy in quantum mechanics. He created Pauli principle, which led to Fermi statistics discovery. He solved fundamental problem how to explain from Mendeleev classification of atoms was solved by Pauli. Pauli rediscovered, you know, people in quantum theory rediscovered linear algebra. Heisenberg rediscovered even multiplication of matrices, that was not known before. That's a big idea. You know, but it was told him that it is known. He learned and created new beautiful physics, isospin idea after learning Heisenberg. But Pauli, everybody will tell you in physics that physicists don't know what is quaternions. Does not exist. Nobody applied in physics quaternions. Not known to them. But they were rediscovered. In every book in quantum mechanics, you will find Pauli matrices. It is quaternions, yes, exactly. Everybody knows, yes, that. So Pauli, in particular, obtained in his works beautiful non-relativistic approximation for four-dimensional Dirac operator, and which I am going to consider it. You can find its derivation in textbooks in physics. It's not simple. Not quite simple. This operator, indeed, it depends on electric field also. This operator has following property. Let me write it. I participated in that works about 1980, studying two-dimensional Pauli operator when physics of surfaces became fashionable. Two-dimensional stuff became real physics. Let me just point out that Pauli operator is direct sum of two operators. In case of electric field, and if electric field is identically equal to zero, and in Lorentz gauge condition, it has following form. It is direct sum of two scalar Schrödinger type operators, but these terms are different of them, and Laplacian from this function is exactly equal to magnetic field. That's orthogonal to plane, so therefore it is scalar function. So I'm saying that this is first spin sector operator, this is second spin sector operator. This is corresponding wave function, first spin sector, second spin sector. Let me invent following operator and tell you following, that fundamental observation is following. The scalar operators are, in fact, if electric field is identically equal to zero, that these operators are factorized, strongly factorized. That's magnetic field is that. B, capital B appeared before, that's nothing to do with that. Now that's magnetic field here, delta phi, in Lorentz gauge form. So this is, if you will make this substitution, perform some calculations, you will observe that purely magnetic Pauli operator in two-dimensional case is direct sum of two factorized scalar operators. One of them is Q adjoint, second one is opposite. And this observation is important. Factorization property of linear operator is very important property. That I heard even from people who made important numerical calculations for bomb business in late 40s and early 50s, that for calculations, even that property with one-dimensional Schrödinger operators can be factorized as a product of two first-order operators is very important property. Very good to work with it if you know that, even in that case. All complex analysis in two dimensions is based on factorization that Laplacian is DD bar. Very important. Factorization property is a basis of fundamental stuff. Let me tell you that factorization property is also basis of the so-called instanton approach, is basis of modern topological studying. Because in for factorized operator, in case of quadratic functionals associated with self-adjoint operators, property is following that minimum of not only of functional, not only satisfies to the Euler-Lagrange second-order equation, but it also satisfies to equation which is whose order is twice less, which call in theory of instanton self-duality equations discovered by my friend Sasha Polyakov jointly with my teacher Albert Schwarz. And so that factorization property appears here. That in two-dimensional case was not far from complex analysis. If factorization property appears, it means a lot of consequences. A lot of consequences. If you have a spectrum of such operators, for example, should be necessarily positive. By the way, in algebraic topology, since important discovery of great man whose name is Hodge, factorization property of Laplace-Beltrami operators on the direct sum of whole differential forms leads to the so-called Hodge theorem identifying harmonic forms with Betti numbers. So that's okay. That's also a result of factorization property. It appears everywhere. The last remark is that factorization property of one-dimensional and two-dimensional operators is also basis of whole completely integrable soliton theory. All beautiful systems of KdV, Kp, ours, and so on are corollaries of this factorization property of linear operators which enters our stuff. It is very important, elementary, very important property which is background of many fundamental theories, classical and modern. Let me tell you that I think that most beautiful completely integrable system model, which I know in mathematics, is just ordinary two-dimensional complex analysis. And this is also that just using that basic idea I created, its discretization different from standard discretization. That's based on equilateral triangle lattice. Factorization property is most important property of also basis of two-dimensional complex analysis, unifying it with modern completely integrable systems, instanton topology, and so on. So, in particular, our results in terms of quantum mechanics are were following. For rapidly decreasing fields, localized fields, whose magnetic flux means integral of magnetic field is finite, Aharonov and Kasher established that K completely found whole family of ground states. It's finite dimensional space of dimension which is indicated here. That dimension with magnetic flux is this integral. If you have periodic magnetic field, means magnetic field, lattice formed by magnetic field, arbitrarily periodic smooth function of magnetic field profile, and integral of magnetic field against elementary cell of lattice is integer number. In natural quantum units, so-called Bohr quantum units, so it is natural integer number. In that case, ground states is really zero, and it is infinite dimensional subspace in Hilbert space, isomorphic to Landau level. Landau level is special case when magnetic field is constant. They are always same, but functional realization is different. There exists isomorphism between them. So this, you see, if you have such positive operators, you know that zero point is minimal point which can be point of spectrum, but it's not necessarily is point of spectrum. You have to find at least one solution satisfying to boundary condition or Hilbert space condition. Otherwise, it might happen that spectrum jumped up. Like, for example, in topology, if you have some Betti numbers, zero, so spectrum of Laplace-Beltramian corresponding part of differential form jumped up if you have not a proper topology, yes, for that. So therefore, that factorization is not enough. You have also to find solution using some additional arguments, which we did. In this case. But this theory had nothing to do with solitons. That just was. Let me just make remark that in 1981, starting from this idea, I started some new type of approach, studying some sort of topological invariant of spectrum, infinite number of integers associated with periodic operator in two-dimensional case, so-called Chern numbers of dispersion relations. And I used idea borrowed from differential topology just to use transversality arguments. They normally study operators starting from words, consider all functions which are, say, smooth or analytic. No, don't, differential topologists will never do that. They will consider transversal operator. Only after that topological invariance appears. Indeed, these Chern numbers, physicists did not even want to consider as potential physical quantities. I published in math literature that I had difficulties with publication in physics literature. Published somehow with topological part at that time. Later, I was already out, there was famous integral quantum Hall phenomenon discovered, and some group of famous physicists partly repeated our job, partly. So that therefore, that there are a lot of topological properties coming out of magnetic fields appears. All ground states in cases which I discussed satisfy to first order equations, so they are like instantons. And spin Pauli operator has two spin sectors. They, in one spin sector, we can find ground states. In another spin sector, spectrum always jump from zero up. So this is the situation always. So in one spin sector, one situation appears, in another spin sector, another situation appears. The magnetic field is associated with oriented plane, so this property depends on the sign of magnetic flux. This is this operator indeed admits also what people call supersymmetry. Supersymmetry is quantum extension of symmetry. The supergroup supersymmetry was very fashionable. Let me tell you, if people don't know that, that there are different quantum extensions of group symmetry, ID. supersymmetry was first one, appears in many physical works, was studied a lot by physicists and mathematicians long since early 70s. A lot of people wrote works about that in mathematics as well. Supergeometry, superalgebra, supersymmetry. Victor Katz classified all simple super Lie algebras. Indeed, it is interesting that Lie superalgebra appeared from technique of algebraic topology in works of famous topologist Whitehead in 1940s early, so a lot of such stuff appeared from algebraic technique of topology before, which was later borrowed by quantum physics. And really, supersymmetry is used as an analog of symmetry. There exists another extension of groups, quantum groups, beautiful work, finally just made shape of it by Volodya Drinfeld, that many years ago in second half of 1980s. But you have to take into account that it is quite different. It never has been used as a really extension of symmetry. It is some beautiful subject, Hopf algebras, nothing to do with symmetry of system, appears in completely integrable systems only. But it does not serve as extension of symmetry. Supersymmetry works as extension of symmetry. And, for example, Pauli operator admits supersymmetry, as it is written in my case, more or less following from the same factorization property of the separators, as I already told before. There were some investigations associated with that. Let me just drop it. But the main problem is that this theory has nothing to do with algebraically geometrical theory of completely integrable dynamical systems which was developed. It is completely different theory. This is that and this is that. Nothing common. The reason for that is following. In algebraically geometrical theory of completely integrable systems, Schrödinger operator appears with magnetic field, or there are some reduction subsystems that magnetic field is zero. Both situations are possible. But there is one important property. If you consider periodic magnetic fields, that picture consistent with completely integrable dynamical system is such that magnetic flux of field through the elementary cell in periodic case is zero. It is, as they say, topologically trivial. Magnetic flux is exactly, I would say, Chern number of corresponding line bundle. And it is always zero. In soliton theory, everything is topologically trivial. In case when we are dealing with Pauli operators for needs of quantum physics, no, we don't consider topologically all our formulas and results about spectrum were dedicated to topologically non-trivial case only, with non-zero magnetic flux equal to some number of integers, which is non-zero always. So there are this discrepancy, that's two different theories. And the question is how to just, we could not find solution of quantum problem for Pauli operators in case of topologically trivial case. It was not solved before. It's what? Topologically non-trivial case was solved. Ground state was found. But topologically trivial case was not solved. That's an interesting point. And this is our idea is to just to make, I would say, to construct bridge between soliton theory and theory of completely integrable systems and quantum theory of Pauli operator. Let me just return to the algebra geometric theory of soliton theory. In 1976, Manakov and our group just developed this approach to two-dimensional systems, but just, and dynamical systems were studied. It was done for needs of theory of two-dimensional nonlinear PDE dynamical systems. And some special interesting cases were found. The following problem you always have to do. It is main problem of this theory. You have class of operators, second order operators. For example, with corresponding to, say, with periodic coefficients. Means, and you can construct to assign to such operator some spectral data. Riemann surface, divisor of poles of some eigenfunction, some algebraically geometrical data, Riemann surface and divisor. And the main problem of inverse spectral theory is following, to find restriction on this data, class of Riemann surfaces, class divisors, such that the corresponding operator is self-adjoint, or have zero magnetic field, or finally is factorized, self-adjoint. This is solution of inverse spectral problem. Dynamical systems helps us a lot, because it's not easy to find this reduction in terms of spectral data, like even in framework of algebraic geometrical spectral data. Not easy. But it is easy to see which reductions are compatible with dynamical systems. That's easy, just elementary substitution. So you can, and the rule is following, that if some reduction of some field or quantity is zero and it is compatible with time dynamics, it means that there exists solution to corresponding inverse problem in good form. Let me give you example of one-dimensional operator where such solution does not exist. Since early times of computational mathematics consider discretization of one-dimensional Schrödinger operator like difference, formal difference, second order, plus potential. You can assign to this case inverse spectral data in periodic case or rapidly decreasing case, no problem. But making a reconstruction procedure, you cannot decide which spectral data corresponds to the case that coefficients are exactly one, that you have exactly difference operator. Additional field appears, coefficient fields, that. And until now it is known that this problem is probably totally unsolvable. What's much easier, that theory of so-called famous Todd-Lattice theory contains two fields, not one for discrete operators. One of them potential, second one just weight of this concerning discretization. Even there exists reduction that potential is equal to zero. I found it in 1975 already. But reduction which reduces to classical operator, difference operator used by numerical people before, does not exist. I might say that is a big problem, and most people think that it is unsolvable in principle. It happens. And certainly this standard numerical discretization does not have Backlund transformation, does not have time dynamics, and so on. This reduction does not compatible with dynamics. That is already so. So a number of physicists in solid-state physics replaced models from standard discretization of one-dimensional operator by such more integrable. You can find a lot of more concrete solutions for that, exact solutions, much better discretization. So even in one-dimensional case, it already worked years before. So therefore, to keep in mind relationship of this area of properties of Schrödinger operators with dynamical system is useful. My ideology in this work is just to get results in quantum mechanics. But it is useful to remember its relationship with dynamical systems. Because I thought first that reduction of field leading to factorized operator is compatible with time dynamics. After that, we worked a long time to get to understand what is really, I would say, relationship in reduction of, I would say, algebra, geometric, spectral inverse data to solve this equation. It's useful to use this trick. In many works of myself and my groups, the theory of Sturriton was used in opposite way, not to solve nonlinear equation, but to solve problem of linear operators. You can treat Sturriton theory as some sort of symmetry, spectral symmetry group of spectral theory of linear operators. It is, one might say that completely integrable systems is some exotic stuff, which we are lucky that some of them are even physically useful, or even important in some cases, or useful, we are lucky. But it is some very, very rare, I would say, small class of examples. But linear operators, which we are working with, is absolutely fundamental first operator. First order Schrödinger operator, second order Schrödinger operator, there's no doubt about that. There are unique fundamental objects. In this, I am going to use this subject also for that goal. How much time I have more now?
5 minutes.
5 minutes, okay. So let me just formulate results. Quantum mechanics is our main goal, I already said this. Let me just list name of authors who obtained, who solved reduction problem for inverse scattering data. Vanya Chernik, algebraic geometer, solved this problem in 1980 for self-adjoint operators. Traditional operators with zero magnetic field and self-adjoint were selected in our work with Sasha Veselov in 1984. And factorizable operator is today's problem. That's where how to find data leading to factorizable operators. There are that very explanation here on the blackboard of that history of corresponding dynamical systems, which works were done leading to this idea. It is interesting that dynamical systems leading to factorizable operator became one of simplest, finally. It is two-dimensional analog of the so-called Burger system, which appeared before KdV. Instead of third derivative KdV, second derivative UXX appears in Burgers. Looks non-trivial, but elementary substitution linearizes it. This is important. And factorizable operator turns out to be associated in two-dimensional case with two-dimensional version of Burger system, which is much simpler. And finally, our result leads to simpler dynamical systems than before. The spectral data are following. You take Riemann surface, split it into pieces. Pair of Riemann surfaces with finite number of intersection points. They cross each other in some finite number of points, gamma prime and gamma two primes. You have to select point, as we call infinities, in each one of them, and you have to select divisors of poles for future function psi. This function psi is described completely with analytical properties written on the blackboard, and instead of hyperbolic case x and y, I prefer to write z and z bar to get elliptic operators because I'm interested in spectral theory of self-adjoint elliptic operators. And if I will this data, all this leading to factorized operator, like that. I'm annihilating this. And formulas can be written for coefficients. This is factorized operator. This operator does not look self-adjoint. However, you can make it self-adjoint using gauge transformation. This operator can be, if data chosen properly, you can make it self-adjoint by gauge transformation. And proper use of data, we borrow it from some special degenerization of Chernik's well results. It is this final statement. Ground state, in case of smooth periodic topological trivial fields, we get different results in both spin sectors where exist ground states, which is point bottom of continuum spectrum. We found also some special interesting cases where everything completely it's bottom of continuum spectrum. This is case of genus zero became enormously rich itself. With, you see, in fact, what it means genus zero. In fact, I have Riemann surface of high genus, but I made Picard-Lefschetz degeneration processes and just collapsing all cycles, joining them. So finally, I get just pair of Riemann surfaces of genus zero crossing each other. And this case is rich enough. Its eigenfunction can be explicitly constructed. And what is interesting, that non-trivial magnetic fields can be obtained from the just as a sum of purely exponential factors, exponential terms with constant coefficient here. And there are two interesting different cases here. Let me point out case when all W here and all coefficients are just real linear forms, real, in the plane XY, and here is positive coefficient. So such function leads to highly non-trivial magnetic field, which has lump-type magnetic field, which has slow decay, but its integral is divergent, and number of eigenstates is infinite. Eigenstates of that cover some convex polytope, for example, for these specific simple functions, convex polytope. That's such that inside you have completely integrable, square integrable function, eigenfunctions, that on the boundary you have bottom of continuum spectrum, big. But we did not choose basis yet. It's like, it's non-orthogonal states, like famous coherent states of John von Neumann. That's even in this lump type case, what is interesting in this relatively simple case is following, that our magnetic field looks like you have linear combination of exponents, like here, simple example. And you consider logarithm of that and Laplacian, maybe 1/2. In case of soliton theory, there exist multi-soliton solutions, functions, potentials. They are complicated nonlinear combination of just originals. In our case, it is simply linear, but it is linear low under delta log. So in original coefficients, magnetic field is nonlinear stuff. This simplicity is exactly transformation which linearizes the so-called Burger's equation. Finally, factorized case is Burger's type case. So just there are also interesting points. Let me point out that we completely solved question which is separates magnetically topologically non-trivial fields with integer number of quantum units with our topological trivial fields. You have to add the so-called Aharonov-Bohm terms, delta function in magnetic field with integral quantum flux. As a last remark, let me point out following. There exists a big discussion, even in today's physics literature, whether Aharonov-Bohm terms affect real spectrum, that makes physical sense. It was certainly discovered, it's Aharonov-Bohm's old works, it's certainly known that if intensity of this term is not integer, in that case, it affects spectrum, it's physically confirmed. But if intensity is integer number, like we appear here, there exists big discussion about that. Our results confirms that it does not affect spectrum. So we compare topological trivial case with topological non-trivial, adding such delta terms, extracting quantum flux, and for that we have ability to construct relatively rigorous theory using approximation of it by smooth potential inside of class of topological trivial fields. So we have really, I would say, good, nice confirmation of that. But our results affects only, we are saying only about relatively stable properties of spectrum, but it doesn't affect it, is not affected some, its eigenfunctions in singular case are more singular. Maybe some more delicate properties of observable properties might be different. We don't exclude that. We confirmed, but we did not prove that. So this is, how we, using also Bohm-Aharonov terms, we made finite comparison of soliton type theory based theory with theory of topological non-trivial Pauli operators, and this is what we did recently, and I told you that our work can be found in my homepage, that's last items of it. Thank you very much for your attention, and let me just conclude that I wish to Mauricio, long, active work in such a good shape as he is in now. Yes. Thank you very much.